Well, people say to me, you know, how do you describe boxing? Well, as I said earlier on, boxing at its worst is a dirty, rotten, horrible, prostitute and vindictive game. They say to me, what are you doing in it? Well, it's only like life. Life's not fair. If there wasn't more good people than bad people, the system would collapse. But you look what's happened for the last 400, 600, 800 years in the Balkans. When you start reading the horror stories come out of the Balkans, life isn't fair. Whether it's Christians again Jews, Christians again Muslims, or whatever it is, and you start looking for hidden agendas, what people have got in their mind. Like I said to them here, how do you learn? See and hear and touch, taste, smell. What's your sixth sense? Anticipating what the other person's thinking and going to do before he does it. People shake your hand and stab you in the back. So I say to the kids, you do as I tell you. You don't cheat. See, I'm talking to you. They're doing the footwork. I'm not even timing them because they know what to do when they come in here. So when I say to them, it's the only game you can legally get killed. You get in with me. You just imagine, I hit you there. I hit you on the temple. Whatever it does, you might have a weak skull or whatever. I hit you, boom, you're dead. I didn't mean to kill you, but it happens. I hit you in the throat. Got me? Hit you at the back of the ear or whatever. I might hit you and break a rib and it pumps you, your lung, your heart, and boom, you die. But there's more people get killed at show jumping, horse racing, than ever in the boxing. Coming down, climbing mountains. But it's what people want to do. But there's a referee in there. You know what I'm going to do, hopefully, and I know what you're going to do, and he's there. So if I'm on the ropes and getting battered, he'll stop it. But as I say, one punch, getting hit right, you're liable to get killed. Is that a fair comment?
That's fair. But it's the intent, isn't it? It's the difference between show jumping and boxing. In boxing, there's the intent to hurt.
Well, it's the intent to hurt. Well, I'm saying to you, people want to shy away from us. It's the only game you can legally get killed. So why, if I'm sat down here explaining to you, you get up and run at 7 o'clock in the morning, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock in the morning, 6 o'clock in the morning, all depends on if you're working. So you're saying, don't drink alcohol, don't smoke, don't gamble. You got one girlfriend, you got enough problems. Don't start playing the field, don't do drugs. You know, if they decide to do this and you're training them, and you don't know about something they're doing, and then they get in there and they're on drugs, or they got a drink problem and they disguise it, or they got a gambling problem and they're worrying about it all the time, or they've got a relationship going and they're having trouble about it, the mind's not on the what? On the job. So I sit down here and I'm doing counselling, I'm doing all sorts. It's 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. But if I'm not doing it, I don't expect you to do it. You see, all the problems I've had with different fighters, it says, you just tell me what I've done wrong on you. Everyone, just tell me. Naseem Hamed, I got him £4 million for 10 fights off Frank Warren. £4 million, so I'm on £1 million. And don't forget, I've told them all my dreams. I'm going to manage fighters and train fighters, which I'm doing. But if I haven't got no television, I'll be putting fights on every 4 weeks to develop the fighters around Sheffield and Rotherham. And so all of a sudden then, I've got £1 million to come. He says, I'm only giving you 600,000. I says, you're stealing 400,000 quid off me. I can't do anything about it because me and you split up now, the whole lot collapses. So I have to wipe my lips and get on with the job until I can become financially independent. And then when I'm out in America with him, and I saw the way he treated Frank Warren and what he was doing. I already tried to explain to Frank Warren 6 years ago what he was going to do. Would have been proved right. It's like now, Johnny Nelson, Ryan Rhodes, Thomas Bradley. Thomas Bradley would be the next one. Thomas Bradley's gone out to Los Angeles with him. Thomas Bradley, that won't last 2 minutes. Because his sisters and brothers, there's none of them nice. You say, well, as they were kids, used to think as they get older, they'll get better and they'll change. But as they got older and got money, become very obnoxious to deal with. You don't need it. You can only sleep in one bed. If you eat too much food, you finish up a fat bastard. It's a fact. As I said to you, the most important thing in life, it's not money. It gives you a bit of protection, independence, that. It's knowledge and wisdom. If you've got knowledge and wisdom, then you understand what's important in life.